let's edit this image. I'm going to do a quick edit. This is 4 minutes long. So the first thing I do is go into Lightroom. I do all my color corrections, my chromatic aberration corrections, enable profile correction. I do any slight corrections that I need to, and then I pull my image into Photoshop. Once I do that, I want to paint the background black, so I create another layer painting the background black. I create a couple of curves layer to see where I've missed. I also select my subject to remove my subject from the painting of the background. This takes a while. I go into detail. I do a refine edge. I do a quick selection and then I refine the edge. I go into as much detail as I can, and then I create a levels layer with this clipping mask. So I have this clipping mask available to remove from the black painted background. And as you can see here, the curves layer, I brighten it up so I can see where I'm missing. And I go and do that correction. The next thing I do is I go into detail. I paint on and off of the layer mask what the quick selection and the refine edge tool missed, or things that look a little awkward. So I'll go ahead and fix that. After I'm done with that, I will flatten the image. Once I flatten the image, you know, I'm still working on that background, so that might take a while. But once I flatten the image, then I go and do the minor corrections to the skin, like the little baby pimples or things that are not normally there. If it's a birthmark, I don't mess with it, but little things that won't be there in a couple of months, I always fix. So as you can see here, I'm still working in the background, but it'll be done soon. And after I'm done correcting the skin, which you're gonna see me do here shortly, I forgot about the cropping. So I want to crop it, make sure it's perfect. I like to work with an 8x10 crop for this type of image. I don't know why, it's just my favorite. Okay, here I am correcting the skin. I'm removing all the discrepancies. And then I'm going to actually, I see a lot of bright hot spots on the baby skin, so I'll create a new layer at 50% opacity. And correct those areas along with the, you know, little bags under the eyes. I just lighten them up a bit. As you can see here, I'm doing all the corrections still. So then I'm going to do the 50% opacity layer, and I'm going to go do the bags under the eyes and the hot spots on the nose. Then I'm going to go and use the Skin Foundation Medium by Pro Touch Totally Rad, and I'm going to paint it at 100% opacity because I like to see where I'm painting. And then I lower the opacity of the layer. So I paint all of the skin, the entire skin on the entire baby, and any skin that is showing on the dad's hands is what I'm gonna go and paint next. Once I'm done with that, I lower the opacity to probably 40%, flatten the image, and then go to my next step, which this would be darkening eyelashes. So I lower the opacity of that darkening eyelashes. I go and do a skin color correction with a select skin tone, selecting the color of the skin tone that I want to correct and painting that on. Another step I do is just a clean edit color base preset that I love, and I put it at 50% opacity. I go into liquify. I do some adjustments to the baby's body and the background. And the next step I do is shadows and highlights. I create a new layer, a soft light, 50% gray. I use my brush in black and white. Black for the shadows, white for the highlights, and I go and paint on the baby skin. So you're gonna see it's gonna bring out more details. Once I'm done with that, I am done, and I pull it back into Lightroom and I do my final edits. The things I like to do in Lightroom after I'm done editing are the noise reduction, slight sharpening just to see where I'm at, and any final changes before I export. This is me creating a black and white copy of this image, adjusting tone curve and contrast, whites, blacks, and I'm done. So hopefully you enjoy this edit. If you have any questions, let me know.